Okay, so for this video, we're going to be talking about the rest operator alongside the spread operator. Both of them look like this, dot, dot, dot. All right, okay, so the rest operator allows us to represent an indefinite number of arguments as an array, and then the spread operator is taking something like an array and spreading them out into individual elements. It's probably easier if I show you, so you know, let me jump right in. So say we have a function called log incidents, and inside of it, we are expecting an array. So an array called incident IDs. And in that, we are going to call an for each statement for this. And then we're going to go ahead and use our new arrow functions. So for each ID in there, we're going to go ahead and log a statement saying, logging, and then the ID. And then let's call that function, call it log incidents. And we're going to give it an array of inc 01, inc 02, and inc 03. If I go ahead and run that, we'll see that it properly logged each one. We're going to be calling this function throughout my script, and we don't know how many parameters that we might actually be giving it. But instead of an array being provided into this, what if we needed to provide a bunch of parameters as strings? In fact, I'm going to go ahead and add a fourth one here. So now we have four string parameters getting inputted into this function. How do we denote that and still make this operate as a for each for all of those parameters? We simply add the rest operator in front of there. And so this three dots basically say, hey, take all the things that are being provided inside of this parameter and then turn it into an array. And if I press run script, the same thing happens. Same thing there. So it's another way to denote it. The spread operator, on the other hand, is all about displaying everything that's available within that array. So let's say I have one array that is that inc 01 and it has inc 02 in it. And then I have another array that has inc 03 in it and inc 04 in it. If I want to combine them, I can just simply do this now. Combined equals the first array and the second array. So what that looks like is that it's taking that first array and it's spreading it out. It's taking all of its elements and then listing them all out as individual elements. So it's as if I was copy and pasting this string in here, and then this string in here, and then this string in here, and so on. It's spreading it out. And so if I run the script, you'll see that this is, I mean, it's showing this array as a string, but you'll see now it combined both of those arrays into one. So those three dots are adding some functionality to how you play with arrays.